はい、こんにちは、メタルギアサバイブプロデューサーのコレカドです。本日は、皆様に、メタルギアサバイブのシングルプレイについて紹介したいと思います。メタルギアサバイブはですね、メタルギアソリッド5、MGS5 のスピンオフゲームです。MGS5 で好評だったゲームシステムやアクション性を生かして、サバイバル要素の強いストーリーモードであるシングルプレイ、そして仲間と共にですね、迎撃ユニットや防衛ユニットを自由に配置して、戦う戦略性の強いコーププレイ、2つのモードがあります。これからはシングルプレイの基本的なアクション、そしてゲームの流れについてと、プレイヤーにとってシングルプレイ、コーププレイともに重要な活動拠点となるベースキャンプについてご紹介したいと思います。サバイブのストーリー
Survive story is not directly tied to Metal Gear Solid 5.This is an apocryphal story set apart from the main Metal Gear Solid timeline, just like the submissions in Ground Zeroes that feature Raiden or Snake from Metal Gear Solid 1. The story in Metal Gear Survive starts with the Mother Base assault by XOF at the end of Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes. The main character is one of the soldiers that was fighting on Mother Base. Just when the Mother Base started to collapse,A wormhole appeared in the sky and sucked in debris, corpses, and soldiers that were still alive. Our protagonist managed to escape this fate. 6 months later, the player is sent by a mysterious organization through the wormhole to an alternate world. In this world, the player first arrives at base camp, set near a wrecked mother base. Food and water are still essential resources needed to survive.A small number of animals can be found here, which you can hunt for food. Crafting is also very important when you prepare for missions. A lot of materials can be found throughout the world that are useful for crafting. You can collect them and bring them back to base camp. Crafting objects requires materials and recipes.You can come up with your own recipes when it comes to cooking, but for powerful items and weapons, you need to get the recipes as rewards in multiplayer. Firearms are very powerful, but ammunition is a scarce resource, so use them wisely. There are a lot of melee weapons in Metal Gear Survive. Every weapon has unique characteristics, so you can choose one according to the combat situation, or just use your favorite.Now we've collected enough materials to craft an oxygen tank. Base camp is enshrouded by a poisonous mist, so we need an oxygen tank to enter this mist. If the oxygen level drops to zero, it's certain death. We need to keep an eye on its levels.
You're nearly out of oxygen.
The story progresses by clearing the main missions. Optional side missions are also available. Both main missions and side missions that are available are displayed on the map.Items, materials, and even people from different places and times are randomly teleported to this world from time to time. It's important for the player to collect materials as they are progressing on their mission. Let's explore the surroundings while being careful of wanderers. If you get spotted by a wanderer, it will call others and attack in force. I recommend you sneak behind the creature's back or kill it with a silent weapon, such as a bow.You can only carry a limited number of arrows, but fortunately, you can pick up the ones you fired. Containers will give you precious items and recipes. You can destroy them to get the items faster, but you can also take more time and open them silently. We found a female survivor. She's still alive. Let's hurry to bring her back to base camp.
Thank you.
The materials you collect are not only used for crafting, but also for strengthening the base camp's defenses.You can build many types of facilities in your base camp. You can farm crops, build water tanks, or facilities to develop better items and weapons. Furthermore, you never know when the wanderers will attack your base camp. You have to be prepared for it at any time. Don't forget to set your defenses. People you've saved will join your crew. By assigning them to the right team, you'll be able to develop your camp further and faster.One of the most unique features of this game is that you can also place the defensive units or interceptor units wherever you want. There are many ways to face the same situation. Where to place the units and what weapons to use is totally up to the players and their strategies. In co-op mode, players may encounter strong enemies or hordes that cannot be fought alone. Cooperate with your teammates to take them down. All the weapons and items are common to both single player and co-op multiplayer. Players can use materials collected in the campaign and rewards earned in co-op to further develop base camp, reinforce weapons and items, and beat the hardest missions.
はい、いかがでしたでしょうか。シングルプレイの基本的なゲームの流れやアクションについて、少しでありますがご理解いただけたのではないでしょうか。これまでメタルギアシリーズは、メタルギアオンラインのように本編のシステムを使って、本編とは違う遊びを提供してきました。メタルギアサバイブは MGS5 で好評だったゲームシステム、アクション性を生かしてサバイバル、コープといったゲーム性を加えることで新しい遊びを皆様にお届けしたいと思っています。最後になりますが、来年の1月オープンベータを開始する予定です。皆様もぜひご自身の手でメタルギアサバイブのゲームプレイを体験してみていただけないでしょうか。本日はどうもありがとうございました。